need to make this amazing French toast are a few ingredients. Obviously, you'll need some toast. I have some organic stone ground wholemeal, which is supposed to be very healthy. Some cinnamon for flavoring. Then I have a very ripe banana, the riper the sweeter, and I just laugh because in the UK my bananas are from Panama, but in Kenya they grow in my backyard. No joke. And then I have some chia seeds, very healthy, high in protein. And then I have some soy milk and it's vanilla flavored, so I don't need to add vanilla flavoring on the side. So what I do is I take my banana and I mash it up. So I'm just using a fork here and I want to get it very creamy. So when I've mashed up the bigger pieces, I add a little bit of soy milk so it can get quite liquidy and creamy. And then I keep mashing and adding more soy milk. It's as simple as that to create the base of the batter. So now you can see it's starting to become like a cream. And then I just simply pour in the rest of my soy milk without making a mess, like me, of course. This should be able to make about 5 to 7 pieces of toast, depending how thick you want them to be. And then I have the cinnamon, and you can be quite generous with the amount you want to add. It just gets absorbed nicely in the toast. And then I'm just adding 1 tablespoon of chia and 1 tablespoon of maple syrup. Or if you have any other sweetener, that would do. Give that a whisk. Then I am just adding a slight dash of salt to bring out the flavors. Now for the fun part, you're going to just dip them toast in. So I just let mine soak for a couple of minutes each. So what I do is, while one is soaking, I'll usually take the one that I've just prepared onto the frying pan. And while that's beginning to cook, the other is soaking. And beware, you might need to use a little bit of some vegan butter, so that's what I have on the side, because the banana, unfortunately, does burn if you're not using the right pan.
Oh my god, that's so loud!
So my ceramic pan was definitely not the right one because it set off the smoke alarm, so use a stainless steel, I think, non-stick pan. It's a black one. That cooked really well. So you can see my little assembly line going on over here. And when they get all nice and golden and brown, then you know it's ready. And at this point it just smells so good. I topped mine with some more bananas, just piling them on top. Altogether, I managed to make about 6 slices of some, I would say, fairly thick toast, so quite a big portion, actually. And look at that goodness, guys. I just ate this today, but I'm already drooling and craving more. I hope you enjoyed, and like and subscribe. Let me know what you want me to teach you how to cook next. See you guys. I am therapy.